Coralliformes. Coralliformes were the second multicellular clade to evolve. Descended from chemotyls, they are sessile chemotrophs similar to earth plants, with the major difference being that they are tied to the deep waters of Reccembra's ocean by their dependence to hydrothermal vents. Like all Duocutin's descendants, Coralliformes have a three-sex reproductive system, meaning only around a third of the population is hermaphrodite, and all the others are either male or female. A Coralliforme's life begins when two gametes merge, and the core cell starts dividing. The floating embryo takes the shape of a small tube of cells, slowly growing taller and heavier until it lands on the ground and sends down a root to anchor itself. All species are made up of one or multiple branches, which themselves are made up of rings of cells stacked on top of each other. These branches continue growing for the rest of the Coralliforme's lifespan, and so the oldest individuals have the longest branches. The small Coralliformes have rings with only one processor cell, surrounded by multiple layers of collector cells. However, this method only works in smaller organisms, so the bigger, more advanced Coralliformes have multiple processor cells arranged in a ring around a central hole used for waste disposal. Gamete maker cells are constantly produced once the organism reaches maturity. They are generated by the topmost ring of cells on each branch, then quickly release the gametes and are reabsorbed by the Coralliforme. Log sponges. Log sponges are one of the weirdest and least common clades of Coralliformes. They grow in short colonies close to the ground and have wide bases to prevent other Coralliformes from growing near them and stealing their nutrients. This, however, doesn't always work, as the other Coralliforme species have specialized to anchor themselves to log sponges, usually starving them after some time. Log sponges have taken the waste disposal hole present in most Coralliformes and expanded it as much as possible, to the point where their body is completely made up of a single hollow cylinder. They have this shape for a reason, as without any branches, they can maximize their nutrient intake by having as much surface area as possible. While most Coralliformes have multicellular bristles protruding from their entire bodies, this trait isn't ancestral to the original Coralliformes, and so the log sponges had to evolve this trait separately. Compared to other Coralliformes, the log sponges' bristles are only located inside their body cavity, which is their main structure for nutrient absorption. Hair grasses. Hair grasses are one of the most widespread Coralliforme clades due to their small size and adaptability. They are really short, only 2 cm tall, and like the log sponges, only have one branch. Unlike the log sponges, however, hair grass is flexible and can be moved around by the ocean currents, which are its primary way to acquire nutrients, as its soft roots aren't made for climbing hydrothermal vents. They reproduce quickly and are the base for most deep sea ecosystems, as they can survive even in low nutrient areas due to their small size. Tentacle shrubs. Tentacle shrubs are small branching coralliforms which use their flexible tentacles to collect nutrients from the water. They make up the most noticeable patches of vegetation on the ocean floor, and usually only grow near hydrothermal vents. Like with all coralliforms, their gametes and embryos travel long distances before settling down, meaning that their young can often be found everywhere. However, only a few manage to make it to adulthood, as they often starve to death long before that. To cope with the high nutrient demand, some tentacle shrubs have started to also rely on marine snow which falls from the ever-productive ocean surface for sustenance. However, this method is not very reliable, and proves little help without the vents' chemicals. Fan trees. Out of the two coralliform clades which could be considered trees, fan trees are the tallest. They grow slowly, and only reproduce every once in a while. However, they don't need to be in direct vicinity of hydrothermal vents, as their nutrient consumption is also very slow. They have an irregular number of flat, hardened branches, which have long bristles growing on both of their edges. These bristles help the organism gather nutrients from the water more efficiently, and so produce more cells faster. Sky reachers. As counterintuitive as this may sound, sky reachers aren't tall coralliforms. Indeed, all sky reacher species grow low to the ground. They are only called this because of how their branches curve upwards at the tip, where a crown of thick but flexible hairs, the coralliform equivalent of leaves, grows. The sky reacher's branches grow low to the ground, looking for a nutrient-rich spot to grow upwards and reveal the crown of collector hairs. Once a branch grows upwards and reveals the hair crown, it stops growing, as it has found a place where it can reliably obtain what it looks for. Fir trees. Fir trees are the other clade of tall coralliforms. They try to maximize nutrient absorption in a similar way to the fan trees, by covering their branches with bristles. However, while the fan trees have a few long bristles, fir trees have plenty of small ones. Fir trees and fan trees don't share the same habitat, as they have the same niches, and doing so would end up with one of them going extinct. Flailers. Flailers are the only large clade of coralliforms to not have hard branches. Instead of having a single root, they attach themselves to a hard surface, may that be a stone or just another coralliform, using small hair-like protrusions on the base of their main branch. Once attached, they begin growing the longest branches out of any coralliform, whose job is to fly around, hence their name, and collect nutrients from the air around the organism.